Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to the Sobha Limited Q2 FY22 earnings conference call hosted by ICICI Securities Limited. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Adhidev Chattopadhyay from ICICI Securities Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. On behalf of ICICI Securities, I'd like to welcome everyone on the call today. Today from the management of Sobha Limited, we have with us Mr. J.C. Sharma, the Vice Chairman and Managing Director, Mr. Subhash Bhatt, the Chief Financial Officer, Mr. Tejas, the Head of Treasury and IR, Mr. Ramesh Babu, the Senior VP Finance, Mr. Vigneshwar Bhatt, the Company Secretary and Compliance Officer, and Mr. Yogesh Bansal from Finance. I would now like to hand over the call to the management for their opening remarks. Over to you. Thank you.
Good evening, friends, and belated Happy Diwali. We are pleased to connect with you today post-declaration of our unaudited financial results for the second quarter, as well as for the half year ended 30th September 2021 through this con call hosted by ICICI Securities. Thank you, Adhidev, and your team for organizing this call. We already shared the operational update of the company in the first week of October 2021. The investor presentation based on the financial results adopted by the board can be downloaded from the website of our company. As far as the outlook of the sector and Sobha's performance is concerned, we believe that the Indian real estate market is showing clear signs of steady recovery, with residential segments recording robust performance in the last quarter gone by. The structural changes in the real estate sector have created new opportunity for the established, financially strong, and multi-locational based developers. However, spike in prices of key inputs is definitely putting some pressure on the margin. Real estate activity gained momentum during the quarter as the country began to cautiously return to the normalcy, and the economic tempo, supported by aggressive vaccination drive, helped people to start resuming their normal responsibilities and activities. Record low home loan interest rates, increased affordability, work from home, significant pickup in the prospects of the IT sector, and increase in the salaries had helped Indian property market to move upward after a lull in the April-June quarter, marked by the pandemic's resurgence and restrictions imposed by the various state governments. The market seems to have factored in the very low likelihood of a complete lockdown, as was seen last year due to the ample availability of the COVID vaccine now. We at Sobha have reinforced our critical processes and have used technology to strengthen our systems and processes and the way we engage with our customers. The company was able to withstand the adverse impact of two successive pandemic waves and show its resilience. We are better prepared now than ever and had already adapted to the requisite digital tools. Like past many quarters, in this quarter also, Sobha had performed well on all the parameters during this quarter. During this quarter, Sobha has achieved its best ever sales volume. It was primarily driven by good sales numbers achieved in Bangalore, Gurugram, Pune, and GIFT City, Ahmedabad. Due to our consistent focus on cash flows and efficient cost management, we were also able to reduce our net debt, and debt equity was better during this quarter. We launched two projects, Sobha Manhattan in Bangalore and Sobha Arbour in Chennai, with super built-up area of 0.88 million sq ft and 0.29 million sq ft respectively in the last quarter. As of September 2021, we have an unsold inventory of 14.92 million sq ft in our ongoing projects, which we consider adequate in the given market scenario. As on 30th September 2021, we have an unsold completed project inventory of 0.44 million square feet, valued at 3.35 billion, which is one of the lowest by industry standards, and it also shows our capability to sell the inventory before project completion. So far, we have achieved 65% sales on the area which is released for sales in our ongoing projects. Committed receivables from these sold units stands at rupees 50.10 billion as of 30th September 2021, which provides coverage of 97% of the balance cost to be incurred on these ongoing projects offered for sale. Going forward, we believe that the steps taken and the improved sales performance will further improve our cash flows, which will help us in deleveraging our debt further. We believe that the second half of this year should be better from the cash flow point of view and from the debt reduction point of view. We also believe that overall this year will be the best ever year in our history, both from sales as well as from the cash flow generation point of view. Some of the important things which we have noticed now is that the dependence on the Bangalore is increasingly becoming less and less, with Bangalore itself showing clear improvement in its volumes. The Gurgaon market, the Pune market, the GIFT City, they have shown much better performance. In the coming quarters, we believe that the Kerala market and the Chennai market also should start doing better. And this gives us a better comfort from the resilience perspective, where somewhere here and there, with the way the economy moves, we should be in a position to consistently show better performance and keep gaining market share in the other markets than the Bangalore one. We also believe that our business model will allow us to keep the cost under control and the margin reasonably consistent with what we have been delivering so far. I believe that the further details on our operational and financial performance, our CFO Subhash Bhatt should be giving to you. Over to Subhash.
Thanks, Sharmaji. First of all, before I start the discussion, I would like to introduce to the investor community Yogesh Bansal, who is currently our finance head for the Northern region, and he will be taking over as a CFO from me in next 1 week. I would request the finance community and the investor community to give him the same kind of support which was provided to me and Tejas, so that he also continues to live up to the expectations that Shobha has created in this market. With that background, I would now summarize our performance for second quarter as well as the half year ended 30th September 2021. First, let me cover the sales highlights. We have achieved the best ever quarterly volumes of 1.35 million sale of super built up area, valued at rupees 10.3 billion during this quarter. The best ever Shobha share in the sale value was also achieved during this quarter, which was 8.54 billion. Coming to the specific numbers, our sales volume, sales value, and Shobha share of sales value were up by 51%, 49%, and 61% respectively, if you compare them with Q2 of the last year. On the sales volume, sales value, and the Shobha share of sales value, as compared to Q1 of the current year, we were up by 51% and 50% respectively. During this quarter, Bangalore has performed considerably better, which is one of our key markets, followed by good performance coming in from Gurgaon, Pune, and GIFT City. During the quarter, other regions contributed 41% of the total sales volume as compared to 26% during the Q1 of the current year. This reflects our potential, and also it reflects on the focus that we have put in to grow in other operating markets apart from the Bangalore market, where we are the dominant player. We have planned new launches of 10.49 million across various cities, and this has been mentioned clearly in the investor presentation. Coming to the cash flow, Shobha, with its continuous focus on cash flow generation as well as efficient cost management, has reported consistent and good cash flow performance during Q2 of the current quarter, current year. We have achieved total cash inflow of 9.14 billion during Q2, which is 33% higher as compared to Q2 of last year. Our real estate division got a cash inflow of rupees 7.25 billion during the Q2, which was 44% higher as compared to Q2 of last year. In all, we have generated an operating cash flow of rupees 1.77 billion during this quarter, which is 37% higher as compared to again the corresponding quarter last year. During this quarter, our net debt has shrunk by rupees 0.39 billion, and this is in, despite the dividend payment that has happened during August. Our borrowing cost too has been reduced during this current quarter, and now it stands at 8.85% as of 30th of September 2021. The real estate division projected cash flow on the projects which have been currently launched, ongoing, and are still to be launched is totaling to rupees 72.13 billion. The details are in the investor presentation, which you guys can have a look at. Coming to the financial highlights, the total income for Q2 of the current year stands at rupees 8.23 billion, which is 59% higher as compared to the sequential Q1 of the current year. The real estate revenue stood at rupees 6.54 billion, which is 74% higher as compared to Q1 of the current year. The contracts in the manufacturing vertical delivered rupees 1.64 billion as revenue for the current quarter. The EBITDA for Q2 stood at rupees 1.6 billion with the reporting margin at 19%. The PBT stood at rupees 6.5 billion with the margin at 8%, and the PAT was reported at 0.45 billion with the margin at 6%. The debt equity, as Sharmaji mentioned, we have reduced it to 1.13 as on 30th of September as compared to 1.15 as on 30th of June. The contract in the manufacturing order book today stands at 22.8 billion as of 30th of September 2021. Of the cumulative sales done in the residential business till 30th September 2021, there is still balance revenue to be recognized in the books at rupees 72.32 billion. On basis of the current market scenario, Shobha has given increments to all its employees during the current quarter, that's Q2. And this has resulted in increase in the employee benefit expenses. The operating activities are picking up, and as Sharmaji mentioned in his discussion, we are expecting to perform better going forward from this stage. During H1 of the current year, the company achieved the best ever first half total sales volume and sales value of 2.24 million square feet and rupees 17.13 billion. Which are up by 46% and 45% respectively as compared to the first half of the last year. The sale value of Shobha share in H1 of the current year is also up 54% on a year-on-year basis, and that was reported at rupees 14.25 billion. We have achieved total cash inflow of rupees 16.32 billion during the current half year, which was 32% higher as compared to the last year corresponding half year. The real estate cash inflow was reported at rupees 12.72 billion during the H1 of the current year, which is up by 52% as compared to again H1 of the last year. We have reported a net operating cash flow of rupees 3.12 billion during the current half year, which is 40% higher as compared to the corresponding half year last year. On the financial front, the total income for half year stood at rupees 13.4 billion. The real estate revenue at 10.31 billion, which was up by 48% and 85% respectively as compared to the H1 of the last year. The contractual and manufacturing vertical revenue stood at rupees 3 billion. The EBITDA, the PBT and the PAT for the half year stood at rupees 2.65 billion, 0.78 billion and 0.57 billion, with the respective margins coming in at 20%, 6% and 4%. That's all from our side, and I would now request the conference holder to open the floor for question and answer.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. first question is from the line of Parikshit Kandpal from HDFC Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi Sharmaji, congratulations on a very good set of numbers. So my first question is on the pricing environment. So we all know that macro factors are favoring the affordability is at all-time high. Besides that, there has been some micro factors. The wage inflation has gone up at a record pace in the southern market. Do you see a possibility of a substantial price reset in the Bangalore market over the next 2-3 years?
Yeah.
That's my first question.
Can I answer this?
Yeah, sir, please. That's my first question.
Thank you, Parikshit, and good evening. See, we do believe that the price rise per se is inevitable. Doesn't mean it is going to happen overnight. But as the old inventory starts getting replaced with the new inventory, you will be seeing on those new inventories higher price realization than what it used to be. We are clearly seeing the opportunity cost of acquiring the land, as well as the input cost, as well as the wage or the salary cost being increased. We are also seeing non-availability in a sense. Now, the demand for the product and the sales velocity seems to be greater than the new supply coming in the market. And coupled with increase in the salaries, especially in the IT sector, and the low interest rates, vis-a-vis the cost input pressure, it looks quite likely that going forward, the price rise will be there, and in 2-3 years' time, definitely about 25-30% increase, in my view, can be expected from the current levels as far as the sales prices are concerned, in my view.
Okay. So my second question is, as you highlighted, that the non-south regions have started contributing at a higher pace. The contribution from the regions are going up. So just wanted your business development plans in the northern market and other markets outside the southern regions, if you can give some sense on the strategy on the business development in the non-south market going ahead, given the growth we are seeing in these markets.
See, we will be going a bit slow in other markets than what we have communicated. Rather, what we intend to do, which we have started giving hints, is that from our existing land bank, we would start leveraging. And especially in Bangalore, Hosur, Chennai, you will see that the leverage on the existing land bank will get accelerated. At the same time, the new launches, whatever we have planned, we are putting more focus on them to fructify. And in the pipeline also, a good quantum, good number of projects are being planned at the design stage, which in due course we'll be sharing with you people. So there is a clear visibility of the newer opportunities in the existing market, and the focus is to move ahead and provide from the supply side the inventory as early as possible.
Okay, so my last question is on the land bank which you have. So the entire COVID thing has accelerated the development of the land parcels, and you being a very large holder of land bank. So from the launch perspective, so over the next 2-3 years out of the current land bank which you're holding, how much of that can be brought in and added to the launch pipeline? So if you can quantify that number.
See, quantification right now, I will not be able to share. But as I was telling that most of these land banks, what we have been talking about since last couple of our calls, right, we have started working on that. And maybe from this coming quarter onwards, you will see greater visibility on release of this inventory as we move forward.
Parikshit, yeah. Subhash here. The 14.49 million square feet plus the commercial power portfolio addition to that, that's about 3 lakh square feet. Together would consume almost 200 acres by the time we launch it from the land bank.
Okay. So my point was more from that, how much we need to incur on the CapEx, because the kind of ramp up in the pre-sales which we have seen in the last 3-4 quarters, especially the run rate we are currently on, that will envisage a larger quantum of launches to be fed in to sustain that growth. So will that growth largely be coming in from the existing land bank, or will we need to incur CapEx on buying out new land parcels? So that was basically I wanted to get an answer from Sharmaji. So what will be the kind of CapEx we will have to do over the next 2-3 years to sustain this kind of run rate on smoothing sales?
Parikshit, parallelly, we are also talking about that we continue to focus on cash flows. We continue to deleverage our balance sheet. And at the current rate also, we have got good quantum of unsold approved inventory. We did 10 million square feet plus likely to come in next few quarters. And good quantum of new inventory is also in the pipeline. And all these things, more or less, the land is paid for. From the newer opportunity point of view, right, somewhere you are right, we may be looking at those opportunities, but the primary focus is to leverage on the existing land bank. Primary focus is to keep growing, keep deleveraging, and at the same time, maybe at some point of time, look for the opportunities you are talking about. But then, right now, very difficult to predict because there is no commitment as such on any of the land parcels as we talk.
And as shared with the market earlier, our current payable on the land bank continues to be in the range of 140 to 150 crores, which is payable over next 2 to 2.5 years.
Okay, Sharmaji, thank you. That's all for my time. And thank you, Sharmaji, sir. And wish you all the best in the next venture.
Thank you, Parikshit.
Yeah. Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pritesh Sheth from Motilal Oswal. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. And firstly, season's greetings to you and your team. My question is on the launches. So post the end of the quarter, have we had any fresh launches, and how was the response, and how does the pipeline look at least for next couple of quarters, if you can guide us on that?
The last month we have launched one project in Gujarat, right? One more project in Bangalore, we have applied for the RERA registration. Once that happens, that project also should get launched either this month or early next month, kind of a thing. Couple of more projects are in the pipeline in Trivandrum as well as in Hosur, which may happen this quarter or maybe the next quarter from a launch perspective.
So overall, we should be launching at least 2 million in this quarter and the next quarter out of the 10.8 million that we have showed with the investor presentation.
2 million each.
No, 2 million this, as well as probably one, some can slip into January, but 2 million by January or Feb.
Okay, got it. And I also noticed one residential launch in Thrissur, which was planned earlier, has been taken out from the launch pipeline. So any update on that?
So police based. So that we have already shown in the ongoing.
Yeah, so we have moved it to ongoing projects because it was a phase 2 of the existing project, Metropolis phase 2.
Okay, got it.
And it has moved from the pipeline into area launch.
Right. And in not terms offered. Of...
it is still not offered for sale because there is inventory available in the phase 1.
Okay, got it. But it's on course. I mean, nothing has changed in terms of that. Yeah. Okay. Got it. And in terms of business development, so we have been highlighting that we won't be taking up any land acquisition. But how is our focus on JVJDs in which part of our existing regions? We are seeking these opportunities in terms of expanding our business through JV, JDS?
We have not ruled out even acquiring certain opportunities as well. What I am trying to communicate is, as things stand today, what is at the design stage or phase which has not been disclosed in our new launches. Mostly those lens, we own them and we are on that. In addition to this, a couple of land parcels in the southern market, we are looking at from a JDJB perspective. Going forward, as and when those things get crystallized, we will be sharing with the market. But rest assured, right, the pipeline is being strengthened with the new project launches. As and when things mature, we will keep sharing it with you.
Sure. Why I was asking this is in terms of competition, because most of the players are right now targeting JV, JDA. So are we facing any stiff competition in terms of acquiring projects through JV, JDAs, or there's still scope for everyone to present in this market with these kind of deals?
Yeah, there is not much of a competition as things stand today. There are very few players in almost all the markets who are competing for the opportunities vis-a-vis what we used to face. Rather, what we are seeing is that there has been basically an increase in both the opportunity costs of buying a land or doing a JV-JD, as well as on a DM basis, whatever opportunities which earlier we used to talk. And this is primarily on account of that inflationary pressure we are witnessing, or the better sentiments we are seeing across. My point is that our current focus, I repeat, is on our own land bank. And somewhere as and when certain transactions do happen on JV, JD, DMA, or outright purchase kind of a thing, definitely we will be sharing. But we are more than adequately covered with the new launches to sustain our business momentum.
Sure, got it. That's it from my side, and all the best. And all the best, Subhash, sir, for your future endeavors.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Monica Sharma from Morgan Stanley. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, good evening. Thanks, this is Sameer here, sir.
Good evening, Sameer.
It's my new name now. on a more serious note, sir. On price increases, have you taken any price increases over the last 6 months across your portfolio? And second, is there a distinction between launching new projects at a higher price? Is that easier versus increasing prices for the ongoing projects?
To answer your last question first, Sameer, it is relatively easier on a new location, new project, to have a better price, incorporating the increase in the construction cost or the opportunity cost of the land, than on an existing project. But what we have been doing, primarily if you look at in last 1 year or so, is that the discounts what we have been offering, they have been reduced to a great extent. Then we have almost moved to the fixed pricing formula, then giving sometimes to get the cash flows as well as not to lose a customer, certain discounts which had been completely stopped. To wherever the new towers have been launched in the existing projects, the realization has been what it was of the last sales in the other towers, sort of thing. So net, there has been an increase of between 1 to 2% on the tower-wide sales. The best example remains our Dreamacres, where I believe this year we may have taken an increase of about 6 to 7% in last 6 to 7 months. Similarly, on the new launch in Shobha Windsor also, we have succeeded from the March launch, the price increase of about 6 to 7% as we talk.
Okay, that's great, sir. The second question is on the use of technology. I think you have also, you spoke about it, it's there in the press release. So can you just elaborate on that? You know, is it on the customer engagement? Is it only NRIs or local sales? And, you know, how is it helping the company?
It's a very good point. We will talk about this on two fronts. One on the technology front, right? We have reasonably now understood, say, for example, the precast technology. And on top of this now, the toilets part, né? We are constructing it outside the tower and trying to fix it, the ports we call them, sort of a thing. So there has been lot of further savings in time and cost in doing this project, where from where we started 6-7 years back to now, we believe this technology we have been reasonably successful in doing. Similarly, on the seed part, on the same technology that aluminum shuttering work, now from one slab to other slab, we have been receiving between 8 to 12 days. Sometimes between 8 to 9 days, we go to the next slab. Earlier, it used to take 15 to 16 days time. So there has been a significant improvement in the building cycle and in the overheads. Likewise, small mechanization you talk about, the technology introduction you talk about, has been an ongoing process with helping us in executing the project. On the sales and marketing side, what we have done in last 1.5 years, we have earlier the sales guy used to head the marketing. Now the marketing got demarcated from the sales people. And then it got centralized in Bangalore. So that was a move which helped us in understanding the marketing as a definitive function, not linked to the selling part. And the person from the outside was roped in. And more than highest number of people have been recruited in last 18 months in the marketing front. Almost 200 people, they work today in the marketing department, which includes a full-fledged back-ended office, which includes the content writers, which includes the people who design the advertisements as well. And the use of technology to see that seamlessly. So from the moment a customer makes an inquiry, to be able to reach out to the customer within 2 to 3 minutes by the marketing guy, and thereafter the way it is being handed over to the sales people, and thereafter we are pushing this same set of customers to go for the site visits. It has all yielded superior results than what we earlier used to achieve. We are having now 7 lakh plus unique data of the customers. We also have highest ever the opportunities getting generated on a monthly basis, highest ever site visits taking place, and the cost being incurred to achieve this thing is at a significantly lower cost than what we otherwise used to pay. And when you say that the 18% stamp duty plus the margin part, the business model further supports us in keeping this marketing cost not only under control, but making it far more competitive. Then sometimes you must be knowing that the outside agencies, they charge 5 to 6%. They keep the data, and we are not sure about whether whatever inquiries which got generated were addressed by the third parties in a 100% foolproof manner. So such things we believe have given us an extra edge now than what we were maybe before the COVID.
Excellent, sir. Very nice. With your permission, one last question. So it's after a long time that both capital market and physical market are, you know, sort of booming, are very healthy. Is it a good option to raise equity capital and then, you know, to power your, you know, the development pipeline further with the help of that. Is that a good idea? Are you thinking on those lines?
See, looking at the size of the market and the opportunities, right? All these ideas definitely do have some merit. But prima facie, like I have indicated, that we have learned the lesson in a very, very hard manner. We believe that somewhere the cost of debt we had not understood as much as we presume we knew. This was the first half after many years we don't remember where we could generate operating free cash flows and bring down our debt. Going forward, I believe that this will get accelerated due to the better focus on the sales management, agreement management, collection management kind of a thing. And hopefully we should be able to power the growth or the opportunity that comes to us with our own cash flow is our first effort. At the same time, such things right now we are not discussing, but maybe once the board understands the opportunity and the sustainability part, I cannot say it is for them to look for.
Okay, great. Thank you very much, sir. And Subhash, sir, all the very best to you. It was very, very, you know, nice interacting with you all these years. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Samir.
The next question is from the line of Kunal Lakhan from CLSA. Please go ahead.
Hi, good evening.
Good evening.
Sharmaji, a few years back, you had mentioned about or highlighted a target of, you know, doing 7 to 10 million square feet of sales in the next 2 to 5 years. I understand, you know, last year or so has been a bit of a challenge. But, you know, now that we have achieved like record sales, would you revisit that target? And if yes, then, you know, if you can give us some timeline by which, you know, you have 10 million square feet of sales.
See, let us first achieve that first the landmark of the 7 million square feet to begin with. Hopefully with the new launches and hopefully right that the way that the market is behaving, sooner than the later, we should be hitting this target. And since our focus has been primarily on the residential space, as well as using the incremental capabilities of our manufacturing units, our design units, and other units for the contracting job, we do believe that we can achieve the 10 million square feet of annual delivery with little bit of changes here and there. And we hope that what we talk about with the Indian economy getting into a new growth cycle and real estate playing its role at this phase of the development of our Indian economy, with 10 cities already under our control, with outside Bangalore doing relatively better than what we have ever achieved, see more cities getting added. We do believe that what we have talked about of achieving 7 to 10 million square feet, we should be able to achieve faster than what we had asked for before the COVID period.
Sure, that's helpful. But let me just ask this slightly differently. Since Bangalore remains our core market, right?
You are right.
We have, say, about, you know, market share of about anywhere between 8 to 10% there. Looking at the consolidation that is playing out right now, where do you think, you know, what kind of market share can we achieve over the next 3 to 5 years?
See, the market to begin with, they will not be like this. As people start seeing the momentum, as they start seeing prices rising, I do envisage, this is my view, that there will be newer players, maybe from the other markets, as well as certain corporates, they may get into this business. Because it doesn't require that way, the entry point is not that difficult sort of a thing. It is like the CEO company secretary exams, right? Anybody can apply for. Getting out successfully is difficult. Not like our NEET or those UPSC exams. But so the big picture is that we do foresee new players coming in. At the same time, I do believe that our market share right now may be about 12 to 15%, not 8 to 10% sort of a thing. And we did the new launches and with the kind of projects what we invested in the coming quarters. These are in good locations, that Southeast regions, which is our forte. Hopefully, we will keep chipping in this market share bit by bit. But the most important thing what I would like to communicate is on sustaining the volumes, and selling the projects before the project gets completed. Now, these are the things which we have been following in a very scientific and systematic manner. Going forward also, we'll keep pushing on that count to ensure that somewhere there is a hedging on the cost increase, or there is an advantage during the project cycle of higher realization if the market so permits.
Sure. Just again, a follow-up on that. It's like, you know, you mentioned that newer developers from, say, newer established developers from other geographies can enter and, you know, gain market share here. How are we thinking about hedging that risk by, you know, like entering into newer markets, you know, especially markets like Mumbai or say acquiring another project in a big market like NCR? How are we looking at those opportunities?
So you are right. That is what, you see, only a few quarters have passed by. And we used to talk about 50 from Bangalore and 50 from outside Bangalore. There has been some delay in the entry in the other markets like Trivandrum, Hyderabad or Hosur. But with the new launches, I do believe that our presence in the other markets will be significantly better and higher. And then in the same markets, we have started looking for newer opportunities. As and when they materialize, we will be sharing, and that way we also will be gaining market share, say in Chennai or in Gurugram or in Pune or in GIFT cities, as well in the new cities where we enter. It's an ongoing process. Per se, the market size is too large. Our business model allows us to compete with anybody on quality as well as on the price fronts. And going forward, these are the two additional, what you call, edge or the strength what we have, will get demonstrated as the market becomes more centralized and more competitive.
Sure. That's very helpful, sir. And my last question is on the cash flows. Subhash, we have seen cash flows, collections from real estate ramp up significantly in second quarter, but yeah, we haven't seen a similar ramp up in the project outlays. You know, do you think, you know, with the increased scale of operations, these outlays will catch up, and, you know, the overall cash flow surplus that we are generating, or we generated in Q2, that may not sustain, or maybe like we'll be still cash flow positive, but may not be at the same level as we have seen in Q2.
No, there are two reasons that are we are seeing for the real estate project expenses not going up at the same level as the collections going up. Few of the launches that have happened with the land being our own land, so naturally there will be no spend happening there, and the JDMs would go down on those clear places, and since the land is at a good price that we would have achieved earlier, so the percentage of the construction cost to the collection would be far more significantly lower as compared to the earlier land parcels, which would have come in at either a JDA price of which is quite high, or the newer land parcels that we would have acquired, like Silicon Oasis or in Marina One. So we expect this to continue, this differential between the real estate project spend and the collections would continue. Probably 5-6% here or there can be the moment during the quarter, but not much.
And Kunal, to answer your other question, our calculation says that in the second half, there will be an accelerated cash flow, which means there is a greater possibility of reducing the debt at an accelerated pace than what we have achieved in the first half.
Sure, that's good to know. Thanks. Thank you so much. Thank you, Sharmaji, and thanks, Subhash. Subhash, all the very best to you.
Thank you, Kunal.
Thank you. Our next question is from the line of Abhinav Sinha from Jefferies. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir, and congratulations on a strong result. Can you just talk a bit if the same sales trend is continuing in October as well?
Yes, Abhinav, good evening. We believe normally the second half has been always better as far as we are concerned than the first half, sort of a thing. And the momentum what we have seen in the last quarter continues. There are sometimes rains or those festive days which normally do not get converted into sales because people start traveling. And the traveling has increased many fold in last fortnight than what otherwise we have witnessed. But the level of interest, the inquiries, the site visits, etc., continue to be well. Gurgaon has done exceptionally well in the last month. Bangalore also continues to do better. Pune also has done well. The GIFT City also has done well in the last month.
Okay. So broadly, I mean, 1,000 crore quarters should become more the norm, right, from here?
Should become the norm. Yes. Yes, I know.
Okay. So second question is on the contractual bit. Now the revenues have been lagging even thus far, and contractual plus manufacturing. And I noticed that there was some improvement in the order book. So by when that order book translates to higher revenue?
Yes. As far as the contracting and the manufacturing part is concerned, we have started seeing increased activities now. Lots of work had been stalled, the orders what we have had. Of late, not only the order book, but the activities part had started showing improvement. The second half should be better than the first half. And by the time we enter into the next year, there should be a significant improvement in the revenue recognition in our context and manufacturing division as well. Per se, you are clearly seeing the companies which had gone very slow had started giving the jobs from now onwards. But initially, when you start the groundwork, the civil work doesn't give you much of the billing. So maybe 3 to 4 months from now, the billing also will improve, and the next year will be significantly better on this front as well.
Okay, so fourth quarter, first quarter is basically the guideline, guidance for.
Yes.
Okay. And Sharma sir, on the last question on the balance sheet, I mean, I know you have done fairly well on the net debt front coming down. Any sort of guidance on gearing you would like to give, or is like a sub 1x gearing target feasible in another 12 to 15 months?
I believe that we have been communicating about 1.10 for the March 2022. As direct equity, hopefully we should be doing better than that as we move forward. That's what I look at. And looking at the current momentum, this is the good thing what we can say with confidence that looks clearly visible that either in the new opportunities or in the debt reduction, the surplus cash definitely will get generated significantly higher than what we have been generating till now. Other thing also just I wanted to put it across, that the quality of the sales now, what we are seeing, is better than what we had witnessed pre-COVID era. The agreements are getting executed faster, and the quality of the collections also is improving. Another good thing what we have noticed now is that across all categories and across all regions, we have seen improvement in the sales. So below 1 crore continue to be about 22%, and more than 50% of our new sales is coming between 1 to 2 crores, and the remaining 22% or so is coming above 2 crore kind of a thing. From the customer's profile perspective also, today more number of customers are buying home below the age of 30 than the people buying above the age of 51 sort of a thing, which is a good sign. From the NRI perspective also, we have got back into the double digit sales numbers, which is a good sign. So on balance, what is being witnessed is that all the regions, all the category of the products, and people from every range of the age, between 21 to 60 year old guys, they have been buying homes. Which is a secular growth we are witnessing after a long, long time. And that is the kind of comfort or the conviction that this is a momentum which is sustainable, which can absorb a little bit of a price hike because of the supply constraint or because of the input increase or because of the lower cost of interest which the customers now pay. And such things will help us in working out both the product as well as the size of the product as we move forward.
Right. Thanks a lot for that, and all the best to you and the team.
Thanks.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, due to paucity of time, that would be our last question for today. I now hand the conference back to the management for the closing remarks. Thank you, and over to you.
Yeah, again, I would like, I'd request Yogesh to say two words as he's in a, starting the position to take over from me. Over to Yogesh.
Good evening, everyone. So, as you know that I already disclosed that I am working with Shobha last 10 years. So, I was earlier handling Delhi NCR and Gujarat region. So, now I'm moving to a new role, that CFO role. So, I'm taking over Shobha sir. So I need, we'll work towards good numbers, and I need your support, good support. Thank you.
Thank you, friends, for your patient hearing. We hope that as we move forward, we should continue to keep doing better and better in our sales, in our cash flows, in our margins. We believe that the sector definitely has turned for the better, and it should be sustaining at least in the near foreseeable future with the good momentum. Let us hope that we can provide a good home to our customers and a good balance sheet to our investors. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of ICICI Securities Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you all for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.